This is George Price, Pendleton, Indiana, and welcome to the Merle and George Show. I think that's what we're going to call it. We talked about this yesterday during a conference, and we had a Zoom conference with several people, and we talked about perhaps that Merle and George Show, and I think that's what we're going to try and see how that works. But before I get started with this, I didn't get much sleep last night, and when we was doing that conference yesterday, I put the dogs outside, and when we got done that conference, the conference was, what, 3-4 hours, Merle, something like that?
Oh, yeah, at least.
Yeah, had a good conference yesterday, and I couldn't find this one. Well, it turns out, and I looked every place, and turns out she had got up underneath the deck and got stuck. And when I let the other dog out this morning, he went up under the deck kind of and was looking up and see there. So I looked, and there's Jasmine stuck underneath the deck, or at least she seemed like she was stuck. And so my neighbor, Kelly, came over and helped me take a board off the deck and get Jasmine up out of there. And so we put another board on the deck so she couldn't get up under there anymore. But I appreciate my neighbor Kelly coming over this morning and helping me get her out of there. But what we're going to talk about here real fast, during this Zoom conference we had yesterday, Giles, what's Giles' last name? He's over in the UK, England.
That's Giles Warham, yeah.
Okay, yeah. He set up the conference, Zoom conference we had, and he managed this whole show. Now, Merle's from Indiana, I'm from Indiana, and we had another gentleman, John, from Sweden.
That's correct.
Great. Yeah. And Giles handled all this, put all this together, and we've got a short video. We'd like to show you what you can do with Vmix and with some other software Vmix has with it. How this works. And tell us just a little bit more about this, Merle, because you may understand what Giles did. He managed this conference, though, again, from over in England, UK.
Well, What he did is something that can almost only be explained by seeing. And it's truly amazing what can be done with vMix.
Right.
What I would like to do before I play this clip is I feel like I need to say that there is other good video out there, other good software video, that is, other than vMix, and Wirecast is one of those. Now, some people wouldn't use anything else, right. But there are those of us that get so excited about what can be done with vMix that we tend to forget to mention the others. So, you know, they all have a trial version, and what I would say is download and try them all. And use what you like.
Yeah.
We don't make a nickel from vMix, and what we just try to do is show people what can be done with it. And my gosh, are we ever lucky to have Giles to help us do that. So with that, I am going to attempt to play this video, and with a little luck, it'll come out just right.
Well, hello, and welcome to another episode of This and That. Fun time messing around with vMix, playtime, whatever you want to call it. With me here today is Merle. We'll go ahead and introduce yourself, Merle.
Yeah, my name is Merle Dixon, and I am from the state of Indiana in the United States.
This is George Price. I'm from Pendleton, Indiana, United States.
And I am John from Malmö in Sweden.
Unfortunately, we've lost John's video temporarily, but yep, folks, you heard that right. We're from all over the place. So I'm sitting here in the UK, a whole 6,000 miles apart from Merle, who's actually sitting next to me here. And this is being done by the wonders of vMix, which is the most amazing piece of software. We keep surprising ourselves with it. I think it would be fair to say, wouldn't you, Merle?
Absolutely. The technology is just superb.
Absolutely amazing. And what do you reckon, George?
I tell you what, there's so many things that you can do with vMix, and they're all time adding different functionalities to vMix, and this is one thing you can do. You need to get John's camera back. Yes. I don't know what happened to his camera, but...
There he is.
There he is.
Hello to John in Sweden. That.
Magic.
Yeah, well, it's only my video that it seems to be acting up. So my audio is working fine.
That's most unfortunate. I'll tell you what this reminds me of. Have you ever watched the Eurovision Song Contest? It's like, come in Sweden. Isn't it amazing, though, that we're just sort of basically sitting in our offices or houses all around the world. Just we're all on our own, just making things happen on our own bits of computer, and we're doing this. I mean, 50 years ago, it was amazing if a broadcast television organization could achieve this effect, but we're actually doing it now just with a desktop PC. I'm absolutely stunned.
Well, George, 50 years ago, you were lucky if you could make a phone call across the street.
Yeah, be on a party line, everybody be on the same line. But no, this is really a cool thing that you're seeing now with this broadcast being handled completely by Giles, and he's over in across the pond in England or UK, and he's handling this whole broadcast from there.
Yeah, that's right. That's something we've not really sort of pointed out before, is it, that we're not only doing remote production, we've got so that, as George has said, I'm actually doing all the switching here in the UK and recording this, but we're in remote locations as well. It's kind of mind-blowing, isn't it, really, George?
Yes, it really is. Again, what you can do with today's technology and vMix and have a broadcast like this, and it didn't take you long to set this up. He was looking how to bring four different people into your broadcasts, and it just took you a few minutes to set it up.
Yeah, I'm amazed with it. What do you reckon, John?
Yeah, well, one of the most impressive things is that the price level that we are operating with here. I mean, just 5 years ago, or even 10 years ago, this would be immensely expensive to do something like this, and now we can do it on private budgets from our private homes with private internet connections. I mean, none of us are operating with particularly expensive equipment, and that we are able to pull off something like this is mind-blowing.
Yeah, I think we're all in agreement there, Mel.
Yeah, this could not have happened as many as maybe 5 years ago. Kudos goes to Martin Sinclair of vMix for making this happen.
Yeah, and I'd also like to recognize Tom Sinclair for making me aware of this product. As you know, I've been looking at other products, but really this product is still amazing me. We're still finding out all the new things we can do with it. It's the most incredible piece of software.
Yeah, I tell you again, vMix, the folks at vMix continually to improve their product and add new functions to it. They've got a whole list of resources that you can live stream to, and add different camera inputs in these virtual sets that you're looking at now. Again, they have made a product, and VMix 18, when it comes out with the shortcuts that it's going to have available for you, there's not going to be a better product for the price on the market anywhere than VMix.
I think you're absolutely right, George. It's it really is a completely amazing project. Have you got anything to add to that, John?
Well, no, not really. I would say that that I'm a recent adapter of VMix. I've been playing around with other software mixers for a little while. And one of the things that has impressed me so much is the speed of which Martin Sinclair is able to adapt new technologies such as the NDI protocol. And now we see activators and even better Mediant integration and stuff like that. I mean, I'm impressed of how fast they've been able to adapt new technology and put it in support into VMix. That is really, really impressive, especially when you compare with competing products. There's no question about it. VMix is the absolutely superior product on the market as of now, I think.
Yeah, I think Merle, you would agree with that, wouldn't you?
Absolutely, without question. I have to admit that I have not tried others, but I see no need.
No, absolutely stunning. Well, gentlemen, we're going to have to wrap this up because we've only got a few seconds left. So on behalf of everybody in the US and Sweden, and from me here in the UK, we're going to say cheerio, and we'll talk to you more about this in another episode. Cheerio, everybody.
And there you have it. What do you think, George? Oh, my goodness. I got your video messed up here, your audio.
Let's see. Now, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can.
I had my microphone turned off.
Oh, I thought I did something.
I thought you were going completely deaf. Huh? But no, that's just a short example of what you can do with VMix software, virtual sets, and you could manage a show from, well, this one was over in the UK, in England. And again, VMix has a 60-day free trial. It doesn't have any watermarks, and you can see what everything it does for 60 days for free. And the software, several different versions from free to a $60 version, up to 4K, whatever you think you would need as far as software. Now, Merle and I don't get any money for talking about VMix, but we've used it for a while, and we like it so much, we just like to have our viewers have a chance to see what the best live production software made can do for them. If you want to do record videos, or if you want to do live streaming to YouTube, Twitch, or some other service. And I did ask VMix if it's going to add Twitter live streaming, and I haven't heard.
Haven't heard back on that yet.
Haven't heard anything back from them whether they're going to add that or not. But I think Twitter live streaming would be a neat addition. You can live stream to Facebook. And again, I don't think for me personally, any better recording or live streaming software available. And that's why I use VMix.
Yeah, really what surprised me about that, or one of the things that surprised me about that yesterday, was the fact that it didn't take him all day to set that up.
No,
I mean, it was just a few minutes.
And there were three of us, and then when John come on, he needed a fourth spot, and he set that other virtual setup there where he could add me and John to that virtual set. And he already had you in there.
Yeah.
And you're in Indiana.
I think it's just fabulous to me that you can do that. You know, 5 years ago, you would have had to have had a huge truck, thousands and thousands of dollars worth of equipment.
Oh, boy.
And maybe a satellite or two. I don't know.
Yeah, absolutely. A few years ago, you would have had to have a truck like CNN or Fox has that they roll around and do live videos from different areas, plus pay for a satellite feed. Now you can do this. They do, like I say, they have a free version or a $60 version or whatever version you'd like to have, about five or six different versions, right?
Yeah, and I think we've just barely broken the surface of what can be done with it, to be honest. So we eagerly await Giles coming on and visiting with us. We should have him on, I don't know, every other week or so for a while, because he seems to always come up with something that's very, very interesting.
Some kind of surprise. I mean, he's always got something new cooking that he can demonstrate and show us. And we really appreciate him letting us use that portion of the video from yesterday during our show here. Yeah. Do you got anything else you'd like to say about Remix or
John? No, that's pretty much it. I just would like for folks to take a look at the little sign that he had about stepbackintime.tv. That is his website. And if you get a chance, go over and take a look. You never know what he's going to put up over there. So
we'll put a link down below to his to his YouTube channel so they can take a look at that.
Yeah, you had a couple of things that you wanted to mention too, I think.
Yeah, you a few days ago, you mentioned something about my huddle cam. I wondered what I had done with that. And it's a $400 PTZ huddle cam. It's made by the same people, PTZ Optics. And it's it's the same company. But I've got that hooked up. And he thought it worked pretty well. So I'm going to, here it is. Here's the picture from the huddle cam. And I can move it around, up and down. Again, it's $400, $395 at Amazon. And I'll put a link to it down below. But you thought it worked pretty well.
I was kind of impressed with it, to be honest. I'm not 100% sure that is PTZ Optics, though.
Yes, they're same people.
Really? Okay.
Huddlecam and PTZ Optics are the same people. I mean, when you look at a video from Huddlecam and PTZ Optics, that same guy you talked about that was on Tom Sinclair's show.
Yeah.
That guy doing a video.
Well, I learn something every day.
Yeah. I wasn't sure either. And again, when I looked back and forth, the same people, how either Huddlecam or PTZ Optics.
Yeah. I thought it was kind of a neat little camera for the money.
Mm-hmm. But, anyway, it's for me, it's been a pretty good little camera and it has worked fairly well. Again, you can see the color of my shirt on green, and back here you can see the color of my shirt.
Well,
and really, it looks pretty good.
Yeah.
So, but you'd asked about that, so I decided to plug it in, and
I do appreciate that too.
Hmm?
I appreciate that.
Okay. Again, you won't find a cheaper PTZ camera any place than this Huddlecam. It's a 3x zoom. It don't have 20x zoom. USB 2 and 1080p video conference camera. And again, I think for the price, it works pretty well. The other thing I want to talk about, photo storage. If you get a smartphone, I got three of them here. I had photos in all of them.
Now, wait a minute. You got three telephones.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I had photos in all of them, and I needed some place to try and back those up and out of my camera. And I came across this. I really didn't realize this, but if you have Amazon Prime gives those customers, the Prime customers, unlimited photo storage free with Amazon Prime. And all you need to do is download the app. And I downloaded it for Android, but I think they probably have it for iOS, for Apple products too. Download this app and sign in to Amazon, and then it starts sending your pictures up to the Amazon cloud. And I got all my pictures on all three phones on Amazon cloud now.
Yeah, that's a good idea too. And you can't have them backed up in too many places.
Oh, no. Because if you got them just to your phone and you lose your phone, your pictures are gone.
Yep.
But if you got them backed up someplace off-site, not where you're at, then you always have access to those pictures.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. And so I'm really glad that I came across that. The other thing I wanted to talk about, and I'm trying to... has a router. TP-Link has a router. Let's see if I can find it. I don't know what I did with that. TP-Link.
Is this the one, George, that you can only use in one room, or was that something else we were talking about?
Yeah. Let's see, here we go. TP-Link unveils the world's first AD router. And the thing about the AD router, it works on 60 millihertz, and it will not transfer through walls or glass or water. but it is really, really fast. The Wi-Fi is 4.6 gigabits per second.
Oh boy,
you can't get a wired connection that's that fast.
No,
it's just, again, blazingly fast. There's not many products out there that can use that yet, and they say that they think that the products will be available this year. Different phones and computers and laptops that you can finally use that AD. I know I got AC devices here, but the AD uses, again, the 60 gigahertz band to transfer Wi-Fi. And again, 4.6 gigabits per second.
I tell you, the way technology is advancing, it just never ceases to amaze me.
Yeah. But there's TP-Link, and I'll put a link down to, if folks want to take a look at that. We'll put links to all this down. We'll put links to the Huddle camera, Amazon Prime Photos for free storage, and again, this TP-Link router. And it's a pretty cool router. So you got anything else you'd like to talk about today?
You know, I don't think so. I think we went through pretty much everything that we had talked about. So.
Okay. Let's see if I can find that a picture of that router.
I hope everyone enjoyed the show today. And
yeah.
Well, we're thinking about it. Now, George and I have done, I don't know, what, three or four of these so far?
Right.
We failed to name our show. I suggested we call it the George and Merle Show, and George suggested that we call it the Merle and George Show. So we flipped a coin, and I guess I won or lost. I can't remember which, but this is to be the Merle and George show. So I think this is episode 4, if I'm not mistaken, but we'll have to go back and take a look and be sure.
Yes, folks can let us know what you think of that name. Should we call it something else? And be nice when you tell us what you think we should call it.
Oh, yeah.
But again, if you've got any comments or questions or criticism about the show, you can leave down in the comments below. But again, we're going to put links to all of this down in the description so folks can take a look at find some of these sites. Now here's a picture of this ADS router by TP-Link, and it's got just all kinds of technology. You can hook several devices to it at the same time and transfer to several devices same time, and it's 332.17 on Newegg.
What was the price of that? 332. Yeah.
332.17. And that's the cheapest price I've seen on this router. But again, there's nothing that only one laptop I think that has this AD technology in it where you could actually use this AD Wi-Fi. My other computers have AC type Wi-Fi, and it's not going to be able to use all of that bandwidth that this thing can push out.
Well, I'm sure there's more to come.
There will be more to come. And I think I was going to upgrade my desktop, but I think I'm going to wait for a motherboard that has this AD technology before I do that.
Probably a good idea.
Yeah, sounds like a real good idea. Okay, anybody, if you got any questions, comments, or criticism, down in the comments. And you guys, anything else for us today, Merle?
All for me. Good night, good evening, wherever you are. Appropriate greetings, and we will see you later.
Okay.